is a great year for Australia's worldwide hit show, Priscilla, Queen of the Desert, the musical. It is back for a triumphant home tour. 10 years, would you believe, after it kicked off in Melbourne and went on to play in 134 cities across 29 countries, winning a swag of fantastic awards along the way. Tony Sheldon is still in the driving seat as Bernadette, and he's been putting on the frocks and high heels for nearly 2,000 shows. Wow. Now let's give him a big Studio 10 welcome, Tony Sheldon. Yay!
Thank you.
Tony, welcome to Studio 10. It's so lovely you've joined us.
I'm so excited to be here.
We are honoured.
A lifelong ambition.
Aww. He's showbiz royalty.
Broadway, the West End, but now he's on Studio 10.
Yeah, I can relax.
There's our promo. Super quickly, 10 years. Can you believe it's been that long and you're still loving the show?
I love it. It's actually 12 years since we did the first workshop.
Brilliant show.
I've been with it that long. And I think it's because of the structure of the piece. It's a road movie. It's Bing Crosby and Bob Hope, you know, in a strange town, and I'm Dorothy L'Amour.
And we want L'Amour and L'Amour.
It's true. And it's that wonderful fish out of water story, and I think that's sort of timeless, and I think that's what people respond.
And also it's life-affirming, isn't it? It's such a positive,
It truly is.
Fabulous
it's about
message.
Standing up for who you are and living out loud and not being ashamed.
Being an individual.
Being an individual.
You said it was timeless, but it's also timely because we've just had the historic vote for same-sex marriage and all of this recognition that's coming, and these are themes that resonate through this musical, aren't they?
They do indeed. Not that most of the characters in Priscilla are that domesticated, but there is the central character of Tick, which is played by David Harrison, our production, has a son who he hasn't seen since the kid was born because he's ashamed of what his child might feel. And of course, as it develops in the show, the son doesn't care. He just knows him for who he is. And living in New York as I do now, I know a lot of, since the marriage legality thing came through, a lot of same-sex parents who've got fabulously well-adjusted, happy kids who, you know, it's not unusual for them. The ceiling didn't fall in.
We spoke with you when you were in New York recently and you were chatting about Carlotta. And how you did quite a lot of sort of research on what had happened with her life in terms of informing your character on the stage.
Yes, indeed. Well, that I grew up in that whole milieu. A lot of people from Les Girls and the other gay clubs used to come to my family's Christmas parties. So there was no great mystery about who these people were. I saw who they were in real life and it was a job. And Carlotta was in the right place at the right time, I think, that she suddenly became a celebrity because suddenly it was all news. So she got to experience the glamour of it. But a lot of the people who work as female impersonators, it's not glamorous. No. It's pretty hard. It's a tough road. And the people in our show, it's a struggle for them to make a living and they have to get out to Alice Springs, you know, to pay their rent to do this gig. Mm. So,
it's also the case, isn't it, that we're talking about the same-sex marriage debate and finally becoming law, that the culture actually sort of leads the way and the politics eventually catches up. And we've talked to people about saying how groundbreaking Will and Grace was. I think here about The Sum of Us and particularly Priscilla, the amazing thing about Priscilla is that it made being weird also quintessentially Australian. It said this is actually the Australian larrikinism and it just happens to be in the shape of a bus full of drag queens in Cooper Petey.
Exactly. It was an inspired idea, I think, on Stephen Elliott's part to make those the heroes of a show where before they'd just been local colour and to suddenly humanise drag queens and make them the stars of the piece and struggling people trying to win acceptance in a hostile environment. It was a stroke of genius on his part.
Disarming the child.
Yeah, now you mentioned the parties when you were growing up were a bit star-studded. Well, you do come from showbiz royalty. Mum is, of course, Tony Lamond, and your auntie is Helen Reddy.
Yes, indeed.
How are they both doing, first of all?
They're doing fine, and, of course, Helen is having a film made of her life.
Yes.
Which is very exciting.
Who's playing her?
It's a new young actress whose name I don't know. I think she's from Adelaide.
And who's going to play you? you? Because you'll have to be in it.
Brad Pitt, of course.
Yeah, because without saying.
I hope it's got the great feminist anthem in it.
Oh, it'll have to have I Am Woman in there.
I think it's actually being called I Am Woman.
Is it? Yes. No, it has to.
And also the nominations you've had and Broadway and the West End, I mean...
It was an extraordinary time, and I'm so grateful to our director and our producers of Priscilla for taking the risk on me, because I know they wanted stars and people like Michael Crawford and Sir Ian McKellen wanted to play my role.
Wow.
And actually auditioned.
Wow. And you just knocked them off?
Yeah. Well, it was wonderful that the Australian producer said, no, we want to take Tony with
that's
us.
That's fabulous.
And I thought London would be the end of it, but then they said, you want to come to Broadway? And it was like, oh! Yeah.
But I suppose your motto should be, I suppose a frock could be out of the question. Because you are frocking up every day.
Sure.
And now you know the agony when you go through the high heels and all and the
and
makeup.
Of course, I'm growing my nails again, which I don't know whether you can see them properly.
They're polished beautifully.
It's a lovely French polish.
I haven't put the colour on them yet, but yes, I wear contact lenses, so that's a daily terror of taking them out.
But do you have to wear the corset?
I have to wear the corset.
So your liver is now up here and your kidneys are
Yes, yes, and the three loveliest words in the English language are when the wardrobe lady says, you've lost weight. Thank you.
Are you getting your own makeup?
Yes, they teach you how to do your makeup initially and then you take it over.
Less is more?
No. Well, now that I'm 12 years older, I think more is more might be the...
more is the more.
Might be the mantra.
And also how to dance in high heels, because I know from experience that is hard.
How do you know this from experience?
You should see my Frankenfurter.
Oh, yeah,
I'll tell you what.
Okay.
If you're Dorothy Lamour in a place. the show had to... Is it true that it had to rewrite the show for foreign audiences? This stuff always makes me laugh.
It always changed subtly as we went along. Like, when they... And it was interesting. When we took it to London, I think everyone was a bit scared, and so suddenly... Yeah. We were talking about English TV stars and the Queen walked across the desert at one point with a corgi. And I think that's when I put my hand up and said, I don't think we're trusting the material.
Yeah.
they had to sort of... There was a line that the character of... Adam, who was played by Ewan Doidge in our production, says, you know, my dream is to go to Ayers Rock and sing a medley of Kylie classics. And by the time we got to Broadway, it was, my dream is to stand on Ayers Rock, which is in central Australia, near Alice Springs, you know, take a left at birth. You know, and we had another line which was, no wonder his father shot through. And our producer at the time was Bette Midler, and she said, oh, you can't have that line in about her father shooting somebody.
Oh.
And we said, no, shot that's, through me. Yeah. She went, oh, that's got to go. So it had to go. Yeah. So we're gradually putting all the stuff back
that's
in and simplifying, and it's given us a chance to look at the show afresh, which is great. Yeah. And we're rewriting lines and making it funnier, which, as you know, is always best.
I can't wait to see it.
Yes.
Thank you, Kathy.
Such a star.
Oh,
we're so thrilled to have you.
I'm so thrilled that they've asked me to come back, and I think the show is better than
I've seen you in the show all over the world.
Oh,
so,
wow.
Yeah. I'm just trailing you now.
Priscilla, Queen of the Desert, the musical is fabulous. It opens this Sunday, the 21st of January, in Melbourne's Regent Theatre, with dates later this year in Sydney, Adelaide and Brisbane. Go to their website for more details. You are fabulous and we love you. Tony Sheldon.
Yeah!